By default, symbol instances always match their source, but we often need to make exceptions to the content or style of an instance. That's where overrides come in. They add much needed flexibility to our symbol instances and save us from having to create new symbols for every small variation that can occur. Now, we've given symbol overrides a major revamp, from making them much quicker and easier to apply to the right layers, to adding completely new overrides like color and individual text properties. When you select a symbol instance, a summary of overrides for the layers within it will be surfaced on the inspector. They're neatly organized by type, like colors, text values, styles, images, and nested symbols. And when I say colors, I don't just mean tints. You can now override the color of any fill, border, shadow, and text layer within an instance. You can view these color overrides in a grid view, or a list view that shows the color variable names or hex codes of each color. When the selected instance contains several matching colors, the inspector automatically combines them, so you can instantly make bulk changes to every single matching property. The same goes for text and layer styles, as well as images. And for additional predictability, you'll also find that mousing over an override on the inspector highlights the corresponding layers directly on the canvas. And colors go one step further, with tooltips revealing exactly which properties the colors applied to. Bulk changes using these combined overrides can be a massive time saver, but sometimes we want to be a bit more specific about which layers to override, which is why we've made selecting layers within symbol instances a whole lot easier. Clicking through the layer hierarchy of a symbol instance now works a lot like regular groups. Double-clicking now dives down a level in the layer hierarchy, so selecting layers in symbol instances will feel immediately familiar. Holding the command key will also let you directly select nested symbols and text layers, no matter how deeply they're nested. And since you may want to grab a very specific shape layer to override its color, a brand new shortcut allows you to hold Control and Command to directly select any individual layer. The other keyboard shortcuts you use to navigate groups work too, like Escape to jump up a level, Tab to go to the next layer, or Return to dive a level deeper in the hierarchy. And since we've made room for double clicking to dive into an instance, the shortcut to jump to the symbol source is now Command Return. You may have noticed we've given the layer list an upgrade too. Symbol instances now show a full one-to-one representation of all the layers in the source. And you can now toggle the visibility of nested symbols from the eye beside the layer name, or by using the keyboard shortcut Shift-Command-H. Pressing the delete key will also hide a nested symbol. And now, you won't lose your overrides when toggling the visibility of a symbol off and back on again. Selecting an individual text layer within a symbol instance reveals an awesome new set of overrides too. In the past, swapping text styles has been the key to overriding the appearance of text, but that meant creating many text styles to account for every variation of alignment, color, decoration, and weight. Now, for the first time, you can override those properties on any text layer, whether it has a specific style applied to it or not. Finally, you can copy nested elements from inside a symbol and paste them elsewhere in your document. There's no need to detach your symbol or view the source. What's more, when you copy and paste a layer or even an entire nested symbol, it'll keep all of its overrides. The new flexibility of color and text property overrides naturally comes with a bit of added responsibility, and we've got you covered there too. From the symbol source, you'll find a host of new options to disable and enable only the overrides that make sense to be editing at the instance level. Now, go download the latest version of Sketch and try out these override improvements for yourself.